Hi everyone, my name is Adarsh Mishra and you are watching Youth Nation Coders. So today we are going to solve our new program, and that question is add two numbers. Okay, so we have got Shivam is the youngest programmer in the world and he is just 12 year old. Okay, and Shivam is learning programming and today he is writing his first program. Okay, fine. And here we have program is very simple. Given two integers A and B, write a program to add these two numbers. Okay, so we are given two numbers A and B and then we have to add these two numbers. So the input will be the first line contains an integer T, the total number of test cases, means a total number of queries which the user wants to ask to us, and then follow T lines, each contains two integer A and B. Okay. And what we have to give as output for each test case, add A and B and display it in the new line. Constraints are the value of test case will be greater than 1 and less than 1000, means the query will be in the range of 1 to 1000. And then the both values will be A and B will be in a range from 0 to 10,000. Okay, no problem. And here we have three number of test cases, then 1 and 2. Value of A will be 1, value of B will be 2. So what is the addition of 1 and 2? The answer is 3. So we will print the answer as 3. Then one more time for second query, 100, value of A is 100 and value of B is 200. After adding these both, what will be the answer? 300. So we will print 300 as answer. Then for the third query, the value of A is 10 and value of B is 40. So we will add that and the answer will be 50. Okay, so we have to solve this problem. So first of all, we have to take number of test cases as an input. So let's open our Python IDE and just write an input command to take number of test cases. Then according to that number of test cases, we will just take input about values of A and B. So first of all, we are taking input and store that variable in a test case. So what we have to do, we are given the number of test cases, so we will loop through that much of time. Like here we have 3, so we will loop at least 3 times, okay, for getting 3 queries, 1 200 22 200 and 1040. Okay, so this loop will do the work. And let's come here. So what we have to do, we have to take two values as an input. So we know that the value of A and B is separated by space, so it means that input is in the form of a string. So what we have to do, we have to write here multiple initialization. I have told you before also, A comma B is equal to, what we are trying to do, we are trying to get a string, which is a normal input, 10 space 20. Then we will break that input from that middle one, middle part, that is known as space. So we will split that input by space, because here we are not passing any argument, then it means that it is automatically setting space as default. Okay, so now this line will give us a list of two numbers, 1 and 2. Okay, so these both numbers are in string form, as in a character form. So what we have to do, we have to map them into integer. Okay, so we have mapped them into integer and then we will store them into A and B. What we have to do, we have taken A and B as an input and now we have to print the sum of A and B. Okay, so that's all. This was your program. And okay, so let's check this input and check whether the program is running or not. Like here we have to save this program. I have made a separate folder for that, CodeChef. What was the question? Add two numbers, I think. Add two numbers, yes. Okay, so here we are, add two numbers and save. So here we have to give input 3, 1, 2, and that's all. Let's check. 1 plus 2 is 3, 100 plus 200 300, and 40 plus 10 is 50. So that's all for today, because this answer are just matching the answers which we are getting here. So this is how we will complete this question. If you have any doubts regarding this question, or like any question related to programming or related to computer science, then you can ask me in the comment section and I will try to resolve those issues. Click on these videos right here and be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.